here we have Dr. Lal at the 79th conference, ASICON. So let's hear it up from them. So Dr. Lal, how are you finding the ASICON this time?
This is a very nicely attended ASICON, very well organized, very heavily attended by both students and surgeons alike. And as we have seen over the last few years, the ASICON has seen a rise in the category of the student trainee surgeons' participation, and that is because of a very strong CME program that the ASICON has developed over the last few years.
So what was your talk about to Dr. Lal at the conference?
So I've been involved in various panels. I took the CME on the case presentations by the students, that was yesterday, and then there was participation in the meeting of the Governing Council, and then today we are involved in the session on metabolic surgery, and then after that there is a chairing of a session which follows that, and then tomorrow I'm doing a panel on acute colonic obstruction, which is something to do with the bowel obstruction. Again, something that is of significance to the problems that both trainee surgeons and surgeons face in their clinical practice. So I think that will make it very interactive. And overall, you know, the participation and the way the whole conference is organized from the point of view of hospitality, from the point of view of scientific content, the bar has been rising every year.
Excellent. So Dr. Lal, if you had one message to tell to all your budding surgeons nationwide, what would that one message be from you?
Well, I think it will be safe, and for that you need to have by being safe we will be making our patients safe, and the surgeons will be becoming safe. So I think the first and the only most important priority would be to be making and endeavoring to become safe surgeons and deliver safe surgery.
Wonderful. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Dr. Lal, so what do you think, like on your personal opinion, what do you think are our budding surgeons challenging? What are the challenges that these budding surgeons facing today?
Well, you know, what is the most important challenge for general surgeons is that they are challenged by the so-called super specialities that have kind of drawn our surgeons away from the broad specialty of general surgery. So these so-called super specialities, which are actually, I beg to differ, they're not super specialities, they should actually be named as sub-specialities, because they're all the coming out from the branch of the mother subject of general surgery. So I think the thing that is happening over the last decade, and more than, you know, last two decades that I've seen, is that very good quality general surgeons, we lose out to these subspecialties, if I may now put it rightly, and therefore we lose them from the core general surgery group. Now, the need of our country, in the whole country, in the metros, in the second B and C grade cities, is to have good quality general surgeons. And therefore, we would like a large number of our general surgeons to stick to general surgery. And therefore, the budding trainees, we are trying to now suggest to the government to add a new program for their training called as MCH in general surgery. So that would give them an MS in general surgery, and the 3 years later that they do their job as senior residency gets baginated or gets recognized as an MCH. So they will be able to get an MS and an MCH in front of their name, which is the reason why they get, you know, drawn into these subspecialties, because they want to get that MCH.
Okay.
So I think that is the greatest challenge. And if you are able to deliver it across the country through good quality university programs in good quality medical colleges, I'm sure there's the future for the subject of general surgery is very bright for the young surgeons.
Wonderful. Wow, wow, wow. That is excellent, Dr. Lal. But out of curiosity, Dr. Lal, but even in other US and UKs, we still have subspecialties, but do they also face these challenges like us?
So it would surprise the audience and even you to know that it is only in our country that there is this attraction towards MCH. These countries, which are the developed countries whom we try to emulate, that is the United Kingdom, the United States of America, or the Australia, or even Europe, don't have anything called MCH. They have the MS or an MD in general surgery, and then they have what is called as the fellowship programs. So they do a 1 year or a 2 year fellowship, so they get trained more and more in less and less.
Wow. Wow. That's a really, okay, I'm just taken aback now. Great, Dr. Lal, great. Thank you so much for your message, and I'm sure your message is going to reach to all our doctors nationwide, and I hope you're having a really good time here in Bhubaneswar.
Thank you very much, thank you for having me here.
For more videos, download the Omnicurus app.